Good morning, my dear friends. Myself is Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande, and today, that is on Monday, 16th of July 2018, I am going to present in front of you audio book regarding Ayurvedic Generic Medicines, Part 9. Ayurvedic Generic Medicines, Part 3. In this today's lecture, I would like to share some very important Ayurvedic medicines which are commonly used in our practice. So, the names of the tablets are, number 1, Laghu Suta Shekhar, number 2, Tribhuvana Kirti Rasa, number 3, Parijatak Guti, number 4, Sanshamani Guti, and number 5, Maha Sudarshana Ghanavati. So today we will try to discuss 5 important Ayurvedic tablets which are routinely used in day-to-day practice. All these my lectures are for my young graduates of Ayurveda who are recently started their own practice, or the last year students, internees, or any other pathy interested people who want to understand little bit about Ayurvedic management. But try to understand, in any of these my lecture is not intended for self-medication by a common man. Of course, I am also meant for the common people, so they can understand which are the drugs available in the Ayurveda. But if they want to consume these particular drugs, they must consult registered medical practitioner. So my dear friends, I repeat the list. Today's list is tablet Laghu Suta Shekhar, tablet Tribhuvana Kirti Ras, tablet Parijataka Guti, tablet Sanshamani Guti, and tablet Mahasudarshana Ghanavati. It is very clear that tablets in Ayurvedic language are called as Guti or Vati. Guti is a small tablet having the quantity of, say for example, 60 milligram, 100 milligram, 150 milligram. So all these are small tablets. They are called as a Guti. But if the tablets are having the strength of 250 milligram, 500 milligram, then those tablets in Ayurveda are called as Vati. So there is very little difference in Guti and Vati. Guti is a small tablet, Vati is a big tablet. Before starting the detailed description, let me clear the tagline for each of the drug. Laghu Suta Shekhar is the best drug for Amla Pitta or hyperacidity, which is called as a Sama Pitta idea in Ayurveda. And Sama Pitta is created because of the indigestion. So whenever the acidity is originated from indigestion, or acidity is accompanied with indigestion complaints, then you can use either a Suta Shekhar or Laghu Suta Shekhar for Sama Pitta. Doctors can use either Suta Shekhar, which is a strong tablet, or a little bit milder form, that is Laghu Suta Shekhar. Laghu is a Sanskrit word. Laghu here is a little bit less potent, minor tablet, secondary tablet than Suta Shekhar. So Laghu is little bit comparatively less potent, I can say. But word is same, Suta Shekhar and Laghu Suta Shekhar. Both Suta Shekhar tablets are for Amla Pitta or hyperacidity. All remaining tablets are concerned with fever. Fever is also called as pyrexia in medicine. fever means pyrexia. In Ayurveda, it is called as jwara. Fever or pyrexia or jwara, it is a symptom and not a disease. Fever can be caused by different reasons. In different diseases, you can get one symptom as a fever. For example, in pneumonia, you will get high fever with cough and chest pain. In urinary tract infection, you will get fever plus urinary tract symptoms like burning micturition, painful micturition, etc. If fever is because of malaria, then there will be fever with rigor. So there are different types of fever, different causes of fever. So fever is a symptom and not a disease. Tribhuvana Kirti Ras is for fever. Then Parijatak Guti is also for fever primarily, of course. Then Sanshamani Guti is also for fever. Maha Sudarshana Ghanavati is also for fever. So today's discussion, we are talking about 5 Ayurvedic tablets or 5 Ayurvedic medicines, amongst which first is only regarding the acidity or amla pitta, and remaining 4 are related with the symptom fever or pyrexia or jwara in Ayurveda. Let us start to talk about one by one. Laghu Suta Shekhar. I have already told you what is the purpose of the name. Suta Shekhar, we have already discussed in my last lecture. Suta Shekhar is a product for hyperacidity or acidity or amla pitta in Ayurveda. But, my dear friends, do you remember? In Suta Shekhar discussion, I have already told you that according to Ayurvedic concept, pitta or the vata, pitta, kapha, these are 3 bioenergies which are called as a dosha in Ayurveda. This is scientific terminology. Don't worry about it. Don't take it in a very serious way. In Ayurveda, when I say dosha, don't translate this word as a fault. Dosha cannot be translated as a fault. Dosha should be translated as bioenergies, vata, pitta and kapha. Vata is the energy for all different types of movements in the body. Pitta bioenergy is meant for all type of transformation, digestion, metabolism. Kapha bioenergy is for nutrition, stability and growth of the body tissues or body elements. Now, amla pitta is a disease of pitta bioenergy vitiation. Amla pitta is a pathology in pitta bioenergy, pitta dosha. Pitta dosha is a pathology because of your faulty eating habits. You eat not at a proper time, lunch time, for example. We must eat in between 12 to 1 every day lunch, and 8 to 9 maximum in India, 7 to 9 extreme. This is the dinner time. But if we miss time and we eat at any time, we don't eat our regular staple food. We always eat for Maggi. We always go for chili, salty, pungent, irritating food. Lot of teas, lot of coffees, excessive eating. And that all causes you the problem of indigestion first. That means you lost your appetite. Oh no, in these days I don't want to eat. Then I have always problem in my stomach. My stomach is always with the full of gas. Then I pass the foul smelling flatus, the gas from the my anus. Then I sometimes get loose motions. Sometimes I get the constipation more over the times. So pain in abdomen, gases, loss of appetite, constipation, these all symptoms indicate indigestion. In Ayurveda, it is called as Agni Mandya or Ajirna. First, you suffer from this problem. 2 months, 6 months, 8 months, year, 2 years. And then you land into the problem of Amla Pitta or hyperacidity. That means you start burning in the epigastric or the right hypochondric region. There may be retrosternal burning behind the sternum, water brush, excessive salivation in your mouth, nausea, sometimes vomiting, sometimes headache. All these are called as the symptoms or the clinical features of Amla Pitta, but they are originated from your spicy eating habits, chili eating habits, sour, pickles, wafers, fast food, and indigestion. There is another hyperacidity. They are originated from without any indigestion complex. They don't have the indigestion. They have the normal appetite. Their stools are normal. Don't have any gas. Only burning. Maybe because of alcohol. Maybe because of smoking. Because of the pitta prakruti. Always eating the pickles, chutneys, chili. Then that is acidity without indigestion is Nirama Pitta. Sutta Shekhar or Laghu Sutta Shekhar, both tablets are for Sama Pitta. Pitta originated with indigestion, originated from indigestion, with the indigestion. What are the contents of Laghu Sutta Shekhar? Sunth, that is ginger. Sunth, dry ginger. Sona cow and bhavana dravya, it is processed in Nagaveli Patra juice. Nagaveli Patra juice. Nagaveli Patra in Marathi it is called as Vidyacha Pan. In English, betel leaves. So, Laghusutta Shekhar is the best drug for Samapitta. Whenever there is a bitter taste in the mouth, nausea, vomiting, indigestion, because Sunth is the best antacid when the Pitta's Dravagun is increased. This is specific Ayurvedic idea. That means Pitta has a different properties. Pittam sasneha tikshnoshnam laghu vistram saram dravam. Pittam sasneha tikshna ushna laghu vistra sara drava. Of course, the pitta has a main property as a ushna and tikshna. But here, sama pitta, ushna tikshna gun is not increased. Try to understand. Ushna tikshna, no. Drava gun is increased. Drava gun, drava property of pitta is increased. So there is indigestion. So what we do? We try to improve the quality of digestive fire. And ginger is the best digestant, carminative. And that's why dravagun becomes less, your indigestion goes away, and your acidity also goes away. Sona cow is also pitta shamak. It also reduces the fluidity or the drava ausha from the pitta dosha. Vidyachi pane, Nagaveli Patra, leaves of the betel leaves. So, this is also the best deepana pachana. Best digestant, best carminative. So, now it is clear to you that Laghu Sutta Shekhar is very similar in its indication or in its action with that of Sutta Shekhar. Sutta Shekhar is more stronger. Laghu Sutta Shekhar, although the contents are totally different, but the action is very similar to the Sutta Shekhar. That's why the name Laghu Sutta Shekhar. try to understand. So 250 milligram tablet, it should be given 2 tablets in the morning, 2 tablets in the evening with lemon juice, limbu sarbat, or even you can give with the vidyatse pana, nagaveli patra. This is the end of discussion of Laghu Suta Shekhar. Now we will discuss about next tablet, Tribhuvana Kirti Rasa. Tribhuvana Kirti Rasa, this is the best medicine for influenza or the flu. Tribhuvana Kirti Rasa is an antipyretic, but try to understand, my dear friends, it should not be given in all types of the fevers originated from any cause. No. Tribhuvana Kirti is restricted only, it should be only used when the patient has a fever with respiratory tract symptoms. He should have tonsillitis. He should have a lot of cough, lot of cold, sneezing, watering from the nose, sinusitis, cough is full in his head, then headache, body ache, there is armor, toxin, there is infection, then there is a fever. So Tribhuvana Kirti Ras is best drug for URTI, upper respiratory tract infection, and also LRTI, lower respiratory tract infection. Only the thing you must remember, that fever is basically a problem of Pitta. Jwara, according to Ayurveda, Jwara word is there. Jwara is related to the Pitta, but primarily Pitta. But you must check out what is the secondarily dosha, secondarily bioenergy. So Tribhuvana Kirti is only indicated when fever is originated with kapha prakopa. There is a lot of, there is a difference in the spelling, my dear friends. Ayurvedic kapha word is K-A-P-H-A. Ayurvedic kapha word, bioenergy, dosha, K-A-P-H-A. But modern cough, that is expectoration, spelling is C-O-U-G-H. C-O-U-G-H, that is cough, expectoration. But okay, fine. Here I am talking the same thing. When you will get the patient of fever with cold, cough and lot of profuse expectoration, sputum, it may be white in color, it may be yellow in color, it may be the green in color. So it may be the tonsillitis, it may be the bronchitis, it may be the pneumonitis. So all these cases can be treated very well with Tribhuvana Kirti Ras, best antibiotic for the URTI and LRTI. But I should to begin with clear you that Tribhuvana Kirti Ras is very hot and strong. It's ushna and tikshna. Hot and hit and hot, hit and hot, ushna, tikshna. So Tribhuvana Kirti Ras, caution, take precaution. There are clear cut contraindications where you should not use the Tribhuvana Kirti. Remember my these words, Tribhuvana Kirti Ras should not be used in all fever cases, in all the patients. For example, if in addition to the fever, the patient is complaining of giddiness, patient is complaining of vomiting with blood, hemoptysis, hematemesis, if there is an excessive thirst, that is polydipsia, then very high fever, 104, 105, then there may be rash on the body, gandhi, udarda, pitta, rash. If there is severe burning in the whole body, in the head, in the mouth, in the urine, in the eyes, if there is unbearable heat in the body already, pitta pradhana, pitta predominant symptoms are there, then don't use Tribhuvana Kirti. Tribhuvan Kirti is contraindicated in Pitt dominant clinical features in the patient. Then, if there is a problem of the patient is too weak, TWO, he has Ojakshaya, according to Ayurveda, immunity is very, very low, he has lost his strength, then you must be very cautious while using the Tribhuvan Kirti. Here, one must understand, common people always say that Ayurvedic tablets, Ayurvedic medicines, no problem. We can use it because there are no side effects. Like antibiotics, they are afraid. No. Antibiotics should be taken under supervision, should be with prescription. But Tribhuvan Kirti is the same tablet. Tribhuvan Kirti should be prescribed by a medical registered doctor. Tribhuvan Kirti should not be taken by the patient of their own. So there are a lot of contraindications. In the Pitta Prakruti patient, in hot summer, Tribhuvan Kirti should be used very, very with careful precaution. Why? Let us see the contents of the Tribhuvan Kirti. Why the name Tribhuvana? It is like the heaven, earth and the hell. In short, what they want to say, Tribhuvan Kirti Ras is so famous in the world because of its strong action as an antipyretic. But where? Where? In kapha dominant fever. Kapha dominant fever. Ayurveda says, Vata kapha jvara. Vata kapha jvara. There is cold, cough, sneezing, sinusitis, bronchitis, pneumonitis, with full of body ache, joint pains. Then definitely you should try for Tribhuvan Kirti. Yoga Ratnakar, this is the text of Ayurveda. What is the shloka? What is the verse regarding the Tribhuvan Kirti? Hingulam cha visham vyosham. Hingulam cha visham vyosham. Tankanam magadhi shifam. Sanchurunya bhavaye tredha. Suras ardrak hemabhihi. Rasaha Tribhuvan Kirti gunjai ek ardha dravenavai. Hingulam cha visham vyosham tankanam magadhi shifam sanchurnaya bhavaye tredha surasardra kahema bihi rasas tribhuvana kirti. Forget about the shloka. This is for only Ayurvedic students. It is from Yoga Ratnakar. My dear friends, contents of Tribhuvana Kirti. Hingula. Hingula is a combination of para and gandhaka, mercury and sulfur. It is also compared with cinnabar, C-I-N-N-A-B-A-R, cinnabar or mercuric sulfide. Hingul, mercuric sulfide. Hingul, it is best catalyst. It carries the properties of other contents and make the Tribhuvan Kirti very potent, having very immediate action. Then there is a Bachanag. Bachanag in Sanskrit, Vatsanabha, Aconitum ferox. This is the best diaphoretic. Remember, Bachanag, best diaphoretic. In olden days, in the beginning, many medical doctors, they only were used to give diaphoretic mixture to control the symptom of fever. Now, in this era, there is a tradition, whenever they get a little bit fever here and there, they immediately prescribe Roxid 150 milligram. Then it may be the azithromycin 500 milligram 1 OD for 3 days. Then L-fluoxacin, gatifloxacin, norfloxacin, this and that. But remember, it is not necessary all the time to start the antibiotic whenever you get the fever. First you go for this Tribhuvana Kirti. Bachanag is the best diaphoretic to make a sweating, and sweating is very essential to reduce your heat in the body, to reduce the fever, to reduce the pyrexia. So it is called as an antipyretic. Then there is a Trikatu. Trikatu is a best digestant. Shuntha, Marich and Pippali, ginger, black pepper and piper longdam. Tri means three, Katu means pungent. All these herbs are pungent, and always pungent is good to improve your digestive fire. Ayurveda always believe that fever symptom is created to control ama avastha of the body. Ama is like a toxin created because of the indigestion, malabsorption, faulty metabolism, and of course bacterial, viral, fungal infections. These microorganisms, toxin, is also called as ama in Ayurveda. So all these ama, all these infections are get cured when you improve your digestive fire, and Trikatu is meant for digestant, appetizer and carminative. Then there is a Tankana. Tankana borax is a very good antidote for Bachnag, because Vatsnav or the Bachnag is originally toxic plant, originally toxic. But we purify. There are a lot of processes to purify. How to purify Bachnag? But still, to control its side effects, there is an antidote of Bachnag which is called as a Tankana, that is the borax. All this mixture is triturated in portal, mortal and pestle, triturated. Bhavana. Bhavana is a processed. Processed with different juices. There are three herbs. Tulasi, that is in German language it is called as basilicum. Basilicum, tulasi, tulsi. Every house in Maharashtra, in India, they have the tulsi plant. Osimum sanctum. Osimum sanctum. Tulsi juice. Alyacha ras. Ardrak ras. That is wet ginger juice. Then dhattura patra ras. Dhattura. That is suvarnakshiri. Piula dhotra. Argamon mexicana. Argamon, A-R-G-E-M-O-N-E. Argamon mexicana. So there are three juices, tulasi, ardrak and dhattura. So we will try to see the action of these all the drugs. First is a hingul, paragandak, mercuric sulfide. It is a kafagna, anti-cough. Shofhar reduces the inflammatory changes in the upper and lower respiratory tract. Hingula. It reduces the secretions. It controls the secretions. It also digests the ama, is reducing the ama, destroying the ama toxin. Hingula is anti-helminthic, antibacterial, antiseptic. Then it is also best with a yogavahi catalyst. Bachnag, again kafagna, vata shamak. It is also best analgesic. Try to understand. Bachnag, antipyretic, diaphoretic as well as analgesic. So it reduces the body pain, headache. It is anti-inflammatory, ama pachak, anti-infective, and yogavahi also catalyst. Tankana lahi, borax, is also visha nashak, that is antitoxic, anti-infective, kafagna, anti-kafa, and also, as I have told you, antidote for Bachnag is Tankana lahi. Tulasi swaras. Tulasi is hot, ushna, tikshna. It is anti-cough. Then it is also good digestant. Ardrak. Ardrak is the best drug, ginger, to reduce your cough problem and also the ama problem, indigestion problem. It is a digestant. Dhattura patra is also tikshna and ushna. Vedana shamaka and jvaragna. Jvaragnas. I am giving you a lecture to increase your vocabulary. Vocabulary of allopathic medicine, vocabulary of Ayurvedic science. So it is a good lecture having a mixture of Ayurveda and the modern terminology together to understand the concept very well. Actually in Yoga Ratnakar it is said that what are the indications for Tribhuvana Kirti? Vinashayat. Jvaran, Sarvan, Sannipatan, Trayodash. Yoga Ratnakar says it is a so best medicine that it can cure many, many types of the fevers. But I have already given you the warning. don't use Tribhuvanakirti in Pitta dominant fever cases. Okay? But it is best for Kapha dominant fever, Vata dominant fever, Kapha Vata dominant fever, and Sannipatika type of the fever. But whenever fever cases are there, you must advise about the overall advice for the diet and also the lifestyle. First important thing is patient should take adequate rest. For any fever, rest is must, because body wants to eliminate, destroy, destruct infection, armor, and you must help the body by controlling your metabolic processes. So rest is very important. Then you should have the control on the diet. You should not, better not to take a very heavy diet, very sweet diet. What you can take? Rice, best, very easy to digest. Then rice plus green gram, rice plus green gram, that is Moog Khichdi, Moogachi Khichdi. Moogachi Khichdi is the best for even taking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days of the fever. It will control your nutrition. It will not make you weak in any type of the fever. Then you can take the different, without chili, without spices, without salt, soups, only steamed, cooked vegetables with addition of the water. So soups are very good because it can take care of your dehydration in the fever. Patient should drink adequate boiled and cooled water, then only fever will be reduced. Because always remember, fever can make the patient dehydrated. Tribhuvanakirti is controlling the fever, controlling the headache, controlling the body ache, controlling the rigors, controlling the excessive sleep, drowsiness. It can take care of all these things. And it starts working from the throat, then bronchi, then the lung parenchyma. Next, it can be used for tonsillitis. Whenever their children are suffering from the cough, and when you examine, the tonsils are very big in size and they are like kissing tonsils. Then also it can be used for the Pashan Gardhab. This is a specific disease, mentioned the word in Ayurveda, that is parotitis. It is a viral infection. It is an inflammation of the salivary glands. This is also when salivary glands are there, lymphoid tissue is there, that is Kapha dominant. So definitely whenever there is a Kapha dominant clinical features, you can use the Tribhuvanakirti. But remember, the dose should be very, very small. Like 125 milligram tablets, 2 tablets, 3 times in a day with honey and ginger juice. Better way, you crush the tablet and take the satana. Tribhuvanakirti tablet can be taken, of course you can take it with warm water, but better to crush it and honey and ginger juice, it will be more effective. But do not forget my suggestion of avoiding the Tribhuvanakirti whenever there is an excessive temperature like 104-105, when there is a hands and legs are palm and burning, then there is a bleeding from any source, don't use the Tribhuvanakirti. In the Pitta dominant Prakriti, you should not use the Tribhuvanakirti. After completing Laghu Sutta Shekhar and Tribhuvanakirti, now next tablet is Parijatak Guti. Parijatak Guti, it is very, very, very similar to the Tribhuvanakirti. This is a brand product from the Ayurveda Rasashala manufacturing company situated in Pune, Maharashtra, India. Parijatak Guti is not prepared by every pharmacy. It is restricted to some pharmacies. One of the pharmacies is Ayurveda Rasashala, Pune, Maharashtra, India. Parijatak Guti, what are the contents? Very simple to remember. Tribhuvanakirti plus Parijat juice. Parijatak leaves juice. This is the only addition. Parijat, Latin name, Nyctanthus arbor trestis. Nyctanthus, N-Y-C-T-A-N-T-H-E-S. N-Y-C-T-A-N-T-H-E-S. Nyctanthus arbor, A-R-B-O-R, trestis, T-R-I-S-T-I-S. This is the Latin name for my foreigners. Nyctanthus arbor trestis is a parijat. plant. We have to use the leaves, juice. What is the benefit? Parijatak is a bitter in taste. You can just, for the comparison, I can say, it's like risochine, chloroquine. Chloroquine we use for the malaria. Similarly, Parijatak guti can be used in the flu, influenza, bronchitis, tonsillitis, pneumonitis, but it is the specific medicine for malaria. You know very well that malaria is diagnosed fever with rigor. Let us understand the concept very clear. In every fever, there is little bit shivering, like feeling of cold. That is called fever with chill. But when shivering is extreme and you need some blankets, you are so shivering, that is called as fever with rigor. And fever with rigor, if anybody asks what are the important two reasons in the medical practice, fever with rigor, only two important conditions. Number one, malaria, and number two, urinary tract infection. Malaria or urinary tract infection, fever with rigor. Fever with rigor. I am talking here only about malaria, which can be considered as a part of Vishama Jvara in Ayurveda, or Shita Purvaka Jvara. Shita Purvaka Jvara, that means fever followed by rigor. What is the speciality? There is a periodicity. That means every alternate day the patient may get fever at 2 p.m., 4 p.m., 6 p.m. Timing is fixed, frequency is fixed, and that's why it is called as periodical fever. Very rarely you can do the hemogram and ESA. In that you will find in the peripheral blood smear, PBS, you write down for the pathologist, dear pathologist, please do, or please check PBS, that is peripheral blood smear, for MP, malarial parasite. And if it is positive, usually we prescribe in the modern medicine tablet risochine or primaquine. In spite of that, or in addition to that, you must start Parijatak Guti of Ayurveda, 3 tablets, 3 times in a day. But here also, I should make you cautious, because it is very similar to the Tribhuvan Kirti. So Parijatak Guti, please also don't use if there is a bleeding, if there is a Pitta dominant features, if the patient is Pitta Prakriti, hot summer is there. Be cautious, be careful while using Tribhuvana Kirti as well as Parijatak Guti. But Parijatak Guti for malaria. Don't forget, whenever there is a malaria, whenever there is a Vishama Jvara in Ayurveda, in addition to Risochin or without Risochin, you must give Parijatak Guti, 2 or 3 tablets, 3 times in a day with warm water or with madh, that is honey and ardraka juice, alyacha ras, chatan, licking purpose. You have to make a test in the honey and ginger juice. My dear friends, 3rd tablet is also finished. Now I will talk about San Shamani Guti and Maha Sudarshana Ghanavati. First, although in the beginning I told you that San Shamani Guti and then Mahasudarshan, but I will take a little bit first Mahasudarshan and then San Shamani. Mahasudarshan Ganavati, as per my personal opinion, is the best medicine for controlling any fever cases symptomatically. Remember my word, symptomatically. Like, for example, if you make a survey in the society, everybody from the age of 80 years to the age of 80 years, a small boy and the oldest people. Everybody knows Crocin. Everybody knows paracetamol. And whenever there is a fever, they go to the medical shop, they take the Crocin of their own, and their fever reduces. I am saying symptomatic management. I am not talking about the original cause, because fever can be caused by 10 or 15 important reasons. URTI, upper respiratory tract infection, lower respiratory tract infection, tuberculosis, then urinary tract infection, then septicemia, meningitis, malaria, dengue, leptospirosis, this and that. There are many, many causes of fever. I don't deny it. But this is the so best tablet according to my personal opinion. Whatever may be the cause, whatever may be the cause, it may be the cold, cough, flu, it may be the pneumonitis, it may be the tuberculosis, it may be the septicemia, it may be the appendicitis, it may be the meningitis, it may be the urinary tract infection. Please, please, my dear friends, use Mahasudarshan Ganavati very liberally. According to my personal observation, I don't find any cases as any complication. So, three tablets, but only the problem is about the little bit dose and little bit cost. I agree. But I personally feel if you want to make Ayurveda more popular in the society, you must recommend, you must keep this tablet at your home as a first aid management of controlling the fever symptom. This is the best antipyretic, analgesic. Maha Sudarshan Ganavati of Baidyanath, costing a bottle of 50 tablet plastic, or rather I can, it is changed now, but 50 tablets cost near about 110 rupees. That is means one tablet approximately cost you 2 rupees. But this is the best medicine for any fever. Without starting your Roxid, Azithromycin, Norfloxacin, Ciprofloxacin, Alcin, Sparfloxacin, Sparta. Please, my friends, don't start immediately antibiotic. In spite of that, please take this help of Mahasudarshan Ganavati. This is the best medicine. Best medicine. Remember, 3 tablets every 3 hours. You see the results. You see the results. Check the results. The fever will come down definitely. Of course, if it is tuberculosis, you have to give some anti-tuberculous treatment. If it is a urinary tract infection, you have to give additional Chandra Prabha tablets of Ayurveda, Gokshuraji Gugul of Ayurveda. Any other medicines you can add, supplement. But Mahasudarshan Ganavati should be the main central treatment part of the fever. In the olden days, when these Ghana tablets are not available, what is Ghana tablet? What is Ghana? First, they take the Mahasudarshan Churna, Bharada, crude drugs, and they prepare the decoction. And then that decoction is boiled, and the concentrated solid part is called as a Ghana. Concentrated solid part of decoction is Ghana. So, Ghana is always potent drug in spite of only Mahasudarshan Churna, only powder mixing, or Mahasudarshan Kadha. Mahasudarshan Ganavati is more potent than powder or than decoction. Also, the another benefit, Mahasudarshan Kadha is also good. I am not denying the importance. Mahasudarshan Kadha, good. You can keep the bottle, glass bottle. But that is very difficult to carry in your home, to carry in your house, to carry in the your job, service, to carry in the school. No, it is not possible. But Mahasudarshan Ganavati or the tablet is a portable. You can just keep it in your pocket and carry it with you. In your purse, if you are ladies, carry in the purse. But whenever you are the fever, having the patient of fever, don't forget to take Mahasudarshan Ganavati tablet, 3 tablets every 3 hourly. Second benefit, there are many people that they don't like allopathic medicines. Even half Kambiflam or one crocin makes them very, very weak. In that way, I can say this very, very sensitive people in the society are little bit sensitive to the allopathic medicines. For them, this is the good alternative. In the cases of fever, use Mahasudarshan Ganavati Ayurvedic tablet. What are the contents? Kutaki, picror haiza kuro. Kutaki is very, very bitter. Taste is very bitter. Of course, here Mahasudarshan Ganavati, when you are engulfing, there is no problem of taste. But I want to tell you the principle of Ayurveda. Any bitter taste takes care of ama, or the toxin due to indigestion or due to the infection. So bitter taste is antipyretic, antibacterial, antiseptic, anti-infective, and anti-ama. So kutaki is the best drug, and kutaki is the main potent medicine herb which acts on the liver. And I should not tell you how much important is the liver organ in our body. Liver is the biggest industry in the human body. Liver is the biggest industry. Lot of metabolic processes are continuing, are resetted, or resetting is done in the liver. Many infections, many drugs, many poisons are destroyed in the liver. So kutaki is improving the hepatocellular function. Note this line, kutaki is very, very good as a liver tonic. You will say, what is the role of liver in the fever? I am saying liver is so important that it is the industry of metabolism. And Ayurveda says, rogaha sarve api mandegnau. How nice principle of Ayurveda. Rogaha sarve api. Each and every disease on this earth is because of the mand agni, weak digestive fire, weak metabolism. Every disease, the disease may be cold to cancer. It may be simple cold, sneezing. It may be the cancer. It may be pneumonia. It may be GI tract problem, respiratory problem, circulatory problem, nervous system problem, excretory problem, musculoskeletal problem. Take any name. Take any name of the disease. But Ayurveda has a principle. What is the principle? Rogaha sarve api mandegnau. Manda agni. Agni is digestive fire. Agni is a metabolic process. And that is why you need, your liver should be very well acting at all the time if you want the quality of life. It will improve your appetite. It will improve your digestion. It will improve your stools. It will nourish the tissues. So liver is very important organ. Don't forget. Mahasudarshan Ganavati also contains Trikatu and Trifala. As I already told you, Trikatu, Sunta, Maricha, Pippali, best digestant. Trifala, in Mahasudarshan Ganavati, Trifala is there. Trifala is making Vatanulomana. Trifala, three fruits are there. Haritaki, Bibhitaka, Amalaki. Haritaki, Bibhitaka, Amalaki, three plants and fruits are called as a Trifala. Hirda, Beda, Avala in Marathi. This is best laxative. It will make your stools very, very nice, gentle, soft. No constipation. Trifala is very good. Very good. To make you satisfaction of the stools. Trifala is rasayan. In according to Ayurveda, it is rasayan. Rejuvenating your body systems. Vatanulomana. Making the good conduction of nervous origin, of chemical origin, of physical origin. Try to understand this anulomana word of Ayurveda. Anulomana, vatanulomana. Vata is for movement. Vata bioenergy, vata dosh. So it may be movement of nervous conduction. It may be the movement of chemical conduction. It may be the movement of physical conduction.
So in all these conductions, nervous, chemical, physical, if the conduction is making smooth, that is called as Vatanulomana in Ayurveda. So Vatanulomana is not only peristaltic movements. This is misunderstanding. Vatanulomana is okay, it is a peristaltic also corrected. But everything has been corrected. Nervous conduction, chemical conduction, physical conduction, everything will be all right. Trifala is good for Vatanulomana, making your stools better. What is the another principle here? Interesting principle. Remember this principle in fever cases. Pyrexia, fever, jwara. Always, always, each and every jwara patient should get at least normal stools every day. Jwara, fever patient should not get constipation. Why? Why? Because Ayurveda says jwara, fever is connected with pitta. And how the heat is controlled? You should have the normal stools every day, then only your body heat will be controlled. If you have the hard stool, if you have the no stools, if you have the constipated, remember my words, your body heat will increase. Your fever will not be reduced. Now there is some common question. They say, our modern doctors, they tell that fever, you are eating less, there is heat. So no problem, no problem. If you don't have the stools. This statement is partially true when the patient is totally dehydrated or patient is not eating at all or patient is on only IV fluids, then I can understand that if stool is not there, it's okay. But if I said patient is drinking a lot of water, especially for the fever, Ayurveda has mentioned Shadangodaka. This is medicated water. Shadango, I will just make a passing reference. Musta parpat ushira chandana nagaraihi shrutam sheetam jalam deyam pipasa jvarashantaye. There are 5 or 6 plants. Musta, parpat, ushir, chandana and nagara. You have to cook these herbs, that is the crude drugs, in the water of 1 liter. Reduce it to the 500 liter, filter it and give it to the patient frequently to reduce the dehydration, to control the fever, to control the thirst in the fever. So, my dear friends, Mahasudarshan Ganavati contains Kutaki, Trikatu, Trifala. Then Guduchi, Gulvel, it is also bitter in taste. This is also the best rasayana to maintain your strength of the body. Guduchi has a multiple, what you can say, the uses. But Guduchi is a very important plant in Mahasudarshan Ganavati. And there are some plants which are helping to reduce your secretions, especially respiratory secretions. Ringani is there. Jeshtamad, Glycyrrhiza glabra, or the licorice is there. These are the supportive medicines in Mahasudarshan Ganavati. Then Ativisha is there. Vekhanda is there. These are all anti-kapha and anti-arm type of the plants. So what is the conclusion? Mahasudarshan Ganavati should be taken by each and every fever patient, 3 tablets every 3 hours with warm water to control fever symptomatically. In addition, appropriate treatment should be taken of a particular disease. Now, only the last tablet in this audio session, that is San Shamani Guti. It is very easy to understand. Guti is a small tablet and this Sanshamani Guti is nothing but only the tablet of Guduchi. So this is the best medicine, Guduchi, only Guduchi. So there are chances of getting any side effects. So for any damp fever patients, like Mahasudarshan, you can give, you can prescribe, you can take Sanshamani Guti in large doses. Why? Because here also Guduchi decoction is made into extract, that is a concentrated solid part. Gulovilicha ghana in Marathi,
इट इज अ घन टॅबलेट. सनशमनी गुटी इज अ गुडूची घनवटी. गुडूची घनवटी. गुडूची इज बेस्ट इम्युनो मॉड्युलेटर. इम्युनो मॉड्युलेटर. इट कॅन रिसेट युअर इम्युनिटी. इट कॅन रिसेट. नाउ आय विल एक्सप्लेन यू व्हॉट इज द इम्पॉर्टन्स ऑफ रिसेटिंग युअर इम्युनिटी. आयुर्वेदा सेज व्हेनेव्हर यू गेट एनी एलर्जी, व्हेनेव्हर यू गेट एनी बॅक्टेरियल इन्फेक्शन, इट मे बी रेस्पिरेटरी, इट मे बी द गॅस्ट्रो इंटेस्टिनल, इट मे बी द युरिन. व्हाय यू आर गेटिंग एलर्जी? व्हाय यू आर गेटिंग इन्फेक्शन? देर आर हंड्रेड्स ऑफ बॅक्टेरिया इन द ॲटमॉस्फिअर अँड एव्हरीबडी इज एक्सपोज. देन ओनली व्हाय सम पीपल दे गेट फीवर? Why some people they get urinary tract infection? Why some people they get the respiratory tract infection? That is because these patients have definitely less immunity. This guduchi tenospora cordifolia, guduchi tenospora cordifolia plant, according to Ayurveda, is the best rasayana, rejuvenating immunomodulator. So this guduchi should be given for any damp fever cases as a supportive medicine to improve the immunity of the patient and to reduce the duration of the fever, to reduce the intensity of the fever, to reduce the antibiotic doses. Guduchi will help you. Definitely guduchi will help you. So if it is URTI, add sanshamani guti. If it is pneumonia, add sanshamani. If it is tuberculosis, add sanshamani. If it is meningitis, add sanshamani. If it is urinary tract infection, add sanshamani. Don't worry, don't worry. It is the best drug, sanshamani vati. But is having a very small in size and shape, it can be used in a higher doses. Especially if it is a case of PUO. After 8-10 days, there is no specific cause can be found, or very rare causes are there of any uncommon infection focus. Then, after or side by side of your investigation, you must continue this tablet from the day 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 10. From any day, you start this sanshamani vati, that will take care of the immunity of the patient. And then if you find something very specific, treat accordingly. But in all cases of PUO, pyrexia of unknown origin, any fever having more than 10 to 15 days duration, more than 3 weeks duration, you must give the sanshamani guti as a supportive medicine to check or to reset the immunity of the patient. But not only that, gulvel, guduchi is the best anti-pitta drug. Anti-pitta. Whenever the pitta is vitiated, pitta is provoked with ushna, tikshna guna, there is burning of eyes. In the diabetic patient, neuropathy is there, diabetic neuropathy. Burning of the hands and soles. Burning of urine. Burning in the stomach. Anywhere burning, anywhere bleeding, don't forget to use guduchi ghanavati or sanshamani vati. Any fever, any bleeding, any burning, what you have to use? Sanshamani guti. Then, as it is acting on pitta, it is also acting on blood. Guduchi is the best blood purifier. Blood purity. If there is impurity in the blood, you get the infection. If there is impurity in the blood, you get septicemia. If there is impurity in the blood, you get many, many dermatological or skin problems like eczema, like tinea cruris, like psoriasis, like vitiligo. In any cases of dry or wet eczema, scabies, pediculosis, eczema, psoriasis, leucoderma, all any skin disease, in addition to your specific treatment, you do not forget to use guduchi ghanavati or sanshamani guti. because it will take care of that thing. Guruji is in general strengthening, improving your strength of the body and also gives the strength to the heart. So in any heart complaint, better way, you can use the Guruji, Sanshamani Guti, as a supportive medicine. Of course, the Anupana will be milk or simple water. So my dear friends, in this today's lecture of nearly 1 hour of 16th July 2018, Generic Ayurvedic Medicines Part 9, I have discussed with you 4 to 5 tablets, Lagu Sutta Shekhar for Amla Pitta originated from indigestion, that is Sama Pitta, Tribhuvana Kirti Ras best for flu or influenza, but don't use in a Pitta dominant cases, Parijatak Guti is for malaria, Mahasudarshan Ganavati for each and every fever cases, better than Crocin, Sanshamani Guti for immunomodulator, supportive medicine in many fever cases, in many skin diseases, burning and bleeding cases. Sanshamani Guti from Guduchi or Gulved. So my dear friends, thank you very much for patience hearing. And I kindly request you, if you really, really like this simplified teaching of Ayurveda, then please subscribe my YouTube channel, share my all the audios or the videos, and ask your friends of Ayurvedic fraternity. They may be Ayurvedic students from first to last year. They may be internees, housemans, registrars, medical practitioners. Please, please subscribe my YouTube channel. That is very, very supportive for these genuine efforts. Thank you very much. Myself, Professor Dr. R.R. Deshpande.